All right.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's right, man. Right, Aki Kareem, British Boxing Television. I'm happy to be joined by Mikey Ramabaletsa, the English champion and the Central Area champion, aren't you, at the minute?
Yeah.
Picking up those titles, man.
I'm trying my best, mate. You know how it is.
Well, it's been a long journey, Mikey. Hard. Yeah.
It is a long journey, indeed. It's been a long, long, long time coming.
I remember when I first met you, you were on a path. You were finding it hard to get opportunities. You had to go and fight away. You had to go fight on the road. You got two title opportunities and you took them, man. You became the English champion.
Yeah, I was blessed to get them opportunities after so long. I've been fighting on the road just to try to get the opportunities all the time. So I was just ready for any opportunity comes. I have to make sure I win.
You found yourself in a bit of a club, which is called the, nobody wants to fight you club, basically.
I find out that, there's no one who want to fight me, actually, especially on a super bantams. But because I'm a champion now, I think the fight should be easy to be made because I've got something on the table. So before I become a champion, I understand fair enough. People don't want to risk it. I've got no title. I've got nothing to say. Okay, I got beat by whoever. This guy is nobody. But at the minute, I'm a champion. I've got a belt. And they have to come and get the two belts away from me. You know what I mean? So nobody want to fight me. I don't know why. As far as I know, when they see you stay in the gym, doing what you're doing, they don't want to take any risk.
Well, now you are the champion. Are you finding it? Are you getting offers now? I mean, obviously we're in a lockdown, and it's difficult. But are you getting offers now at the minute?
To be honest, I think for me the lockdown helped me a lot because remember I've been training. The last year I've been training the whole 12 months with no fight, and my body was just getting a lot of injuries. I was not getting rest because I was not too sure when I'm going to get a fight. So when the lockdown comes, at least my body starts to recover, and start again from the scratch to build up the fitness. So I think it helped me a lot and spending time with my family because most of the time we're just traveling, being in the gym all the time, sacrificing because I want to be fighting for the big fight so bad because I know where I belong, that's the problem.
How are you going to get to that stage then, do you feel, where you will get a break at a big fight where, there's going to be a good purse and it's going to be something which you can establish yourself with?
Actually, what's happening is I was meant to fight Shabazz. Actually, Shabazz is a mandatory for my title.
Shabazz and Maverick Masood.
Yeah. So yeah. I don't know. I've been listening to his interview before. I know he was talking confident, saying that he's gonna take the fight, and recently I've been listening to the interviews. It seems like he's not too sure whether he's gonna take the fight or not. Which is I respect if ever maybe he's not too sure, he's not ready for the fight, fair enough, I respect that, but he just gave to just to say and step down and give other people a chance to come and challenge the title. That's what I want. The main thing is I hope I'll get the opportunity to fight. If he doesn't want to take the fight, I'll get the opportunity to fight Chris Berg. He just boxed for area title. I think he just won area title. Is that last Saturday?
Yeah.
So if Shabazz don't want the fight, and then I think I'll get Chris back on BT Sport. So hopefully maybe the fight will be in late September because he just boxed anyway.
You know, interesting. I mean, I've not been following too much this last week because I've got my wife's expecting any day. So I've not been following as much, but so I've not seen this with you and Shabazz, but that sounds like a great fight. He's a young up and coming prospect. Very skillful lad. Good team, Asghi and Ben Davison, quality team. That would be a great fight, you know.
And don't take me wrong. I think Shabazz is going to be a good fight.
Yeah.
He's a good kid. He's coming up. But the thing is, they only realize when they stop in the ring with me. Because, Shabazz knows me very well. And he's a very good kid. He's skillful and all that. But in a championship level, it's another level. It's another story. And I've been in this game for too long, so I cannot afford to lose. And I think he's going to be a champion when the time comes for him anyway. Not now, because whoever comes in a super bantam, I don't run away from anybody. Any super bantam in the country, I'm willing to face any super bantam who has a title. I want to show that I'm the best super bantam in the country. And I want to show the world that I belong among the best. You know, sometimes I'm saying it. I know people. It's easy to say it, but I know when you talk. But I know deep down in my heart, you know how much I work hard, and I've got what it takes to be among the best. And it's just a matter of time.
Do you, if any promoters are watching who are looking to put on shows, you know, when things resume properly, you know, would you take a fight at short notice if they need someone, or would you? I mean, is it literally? Are you saying to anyone, "Get me in there," basically, or you know, what factors would there be for you to take a fight at short notice?
You know, to take any fight, any opportunity for the title, if I'm not defending my title, obviously they're gonna give me a short notice. But I'm willing to do whatever it takes. It depends if the money's all right. I'm not taking the fight to lose. That's the one thing it's business. At the end of the day, I need to get a good money. But out there, I've been giving shout out to Eddie Hearn to give me the fight if ever against any super bantam that he has. Frank Warren, they know anyway. So I'm willing to fight any super bantam in the country that he think he is willing to take the title. I want to fight for the title, so I don't want to be fighting maybe 6 round, 8 round. No, I'm not. I've passed that level a long time.
Yeah. I mean, for you, it's been a story of you've not had it sort of made in the same way where, you know, you have a massive, massive, massive promoter who can put you on a show regularly. You've had to almost self-promote yourself at times. You've had some really good trainers as well in the past, obviously, and some good... But where are you now management-wise, and who's representing you at the minute?
I'm working with Kevin Murray. Kevin Murray is my manager. Yeah, so he's helping me a lot. That's why the fight is gonna happen on BT Sport because of him. Yeah. You know, he's trying his best to get the contract for me to get the big fight. So yeah.
He's got a lot of contacts. He's a very good manager as well. So he may be able to get you these opportunities that you're looking for.
Yeah, definitely. He don't sit down. I mean, all the time, probably every day, he updates me with things that he's doing for me. So I really, really appreciate things that he's doing for me. It's amazing. So I know. I mean, like I always say, sometimes it takes time, but whatever, it doesn't matter how long it takes, but it's going to happen. That's what I always believe, that it doesn't matter how long it takes. I know it's hard. It takes time. I want to make history. You know, I want to make history. I want to show the people, the upcoming superstars, young stars, or anybody out there who just generally life would like to give up on chasing their dreams for some reasons. I just want to show them that, you know what, don't ever give up, because there's an opportunity for you to achieve your goals as long as you don't give up in life.
Well, that's a great message. And, you know, you're coming off two of your best performances, two of your best wins, and you've shown that when you are given an opportunity, you can really turn up the gas.
100%. Because I don't want to lose. At the minute, losing is another option, and I'll fight to win. That's why I sacrifice so much, being in the gym, do things that I'm doing. I'm running. I'm doing absolutely crazy. You know, I can see the vision. I can see the light. You know, but I don't know when it's gonna come. But I know definitely it's gonna turn up, and I'll show the world that I deserve to be among the best. So that all I need is just the opportunity from all the top promoters to give me that shot. Then I can show the world that I belong among the best.
If any of them do watch this, give them a message, man. Give them a direct message.
HD, Adrian, Frank Waring. Can you please, any super bantam that they have to sign the contract and defend my title, you know, on live on BT Sports, it shows the world that I deserve. This is my time. I want to show the world that, you know, you don't give up in life and don't listen to nobody. So I need an opportunity to defend my title live on BT Sport. Frank, if there's any super bantam that you trust has the title, let's make it happen. I want to fight the big fight. I want to fight the champions. So that's how I can prove that how best I am.
You know, it's a very strange world, boxing, isn't it? I mean, you're the champion and you're calling people, like, there's no one calling you.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Because before I used to call all the names. So now I just want to call all the champions. I don't want to call names, but anybody who has the title as a champion, I'm here and I'm willing to take a risk. You know, I'm willing to conquer anything. Whoever on my way, I want to go and conquer the world. Let's make it happen.
Let's make it happen, baby. Listen, it's lovely to catch up with you.
Yeah, hopefully, maybe I'll get the opportunity for Bridgie title as well. So I'm just crossing my fingers whether after defending my title, I may get an opportunity for Bridgie title. There's no doubt I'll lose. I'll make the history.
Mikey, it's been great watching your journey so far. The way you've carried on going has been great to watch. And I hope there's some final chapters left for you, man, to get an opportunity you deserve.
All right, thanks, buddy. Thank you. And I really appreciate your support. You always give me the shout all the time since the late Oliver, you know, since, man. And I really, really appreciate that, man.
Anytime, mate. And it was lovely to first meet you down at Oliver's gym.
Before I go, I just want to say thanks to all my sponsors. Without them, I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing. I really appreciate your help. It makes a massive, massive, massive difference in my life. So without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing. And thank you so much.
You want to give them a shout out, the names of them, the sponsors, or...?
Yeah, okay. I just want to say thanks to my manager, to my trainer, Kevin Morey, my manager, Mickey Day, my trainer, with their help, with what they're doing for me. Thank you, Kev, with the hard work you put in for me to get the big fight. I really appreciate everything you're doing for me. And I want to say thanks to my sponsors. Without my sponsors, I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing. I really appreciate your help, guys. Thank you so much. I want to say thanks to Global Green CBD. I want to say thanks to Good Side, Bad Side Clothing, Link Kitchen Preston, Smart Fitness Preston, Athletic Security, Soul Food Station, and all three health. Without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing, and Again, the last one is Sapphire Accounting. Really, really appreciate your help, guys, so much. Without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing. I swear to God. But now we're chasing the big fight, and we're ready to conquer the world. And this opportunity is gonna come, and I'll shock the world. Let's go, champ. Thank you, guys. I really appreciate your help. Let's go, champ.